Hey guys, welcome back to my channel.
Boy out of my boots, huh? Hop in the whip and go vroom. Nigga thought that I go boom. I won't even break a sweat.
So in today's video, I'm going to be doing something that has been so requested. I am so excited to finally be doing this video and just to be filming another sit down video. I take for granted just how fun it is to really just be able to film like this. Today I'm chilling at home. I got home from the beach yesterday. Happy New Year, by the way. As you guys may know from one of my recent videos, I did recently purchase a new MacBook. So thankful for this. Editing will only get better from here. So currently on this computer, I'm still using iMovie. That's what I've been using pretty much since I've started YouTube. It's super easy, it's simple, and you can still get really good videos out of it. So that's what I'm gonna be editing on today and showing you guys kind of how I use it and how I put my videos together. So today's video that I'm gonna be editing is mainly a packing video. I filmed me packing to get ready to go to the beach. I also filmed some at the beach, but I didn't get enough footage to make a whole video out of it. So I'm gonna be mashing these two videos together. So this is actually something different than I'd usually be posting. This is gonna be interesting because I don't even know exactly what I'm gonna be doing. I never do. I kind of just go with the flow. And once I get in like a rhythm, I just usually finish the whole video in one sitting. So I have my SD card here. This is the one I usually use. It's a 128 gigabyte SD card. Pretty much never run out of storage. With this SD card, I can film like 5 videos on here and not delete anything off of this card. So there's still quite a few videos on here. I usually just don't feel like deleting them. I'm gonna be using this, and then I have this attachment here because the newer MacBooks don't have the regular SD slot. So I'm just gonna plug this into the outlet. You just put the SD card. This is weird. You just put the SD card in here. I figured out how to screen record my computer a few days ago. So that's how I'm gonna be showing you guys what I'm doing on my computer. So just kind of go back and forth from me talking, and then I'll put the overlay of my computer screen on the screen so you guys know what I'm doing. Let me start screen recording now.
And we are live.
First, I'm just gonna open iMovie, obviously. I'm actually trying to work on a new intro right now. Yes, I am making a new intro. I am sorry. I know a lot of you guys like it, and it's kind of like a trademark for my channel now. And it always will be. It'll always be like a thing that we can all like connect with, you know. May even be on merch, even if it's not my current intro, if you guys would be interested in that. But I know a lot of you guys like my intro, but personally I am so tired of it. I can't stand the song anymore. I always skip past my intro whenever I look over my videos, so I'm gonna be changing it. I'm sorry, please don't attack me. Things need to change, you know. I like change. I don't like staying in the same spot. Like, I like to be moving forward and progressing with things. So we're changing it. I'm sorry. So I am now in iMovie. I only have 2 projects on here because I just got this computer. So basically you're gonna create a new movie. Really simple. I already have my SD card in my computer. So usually when you do this, I'll show you guys. Whenever you first plug it in, all of your clips that are on your SD card will kind of just pop up on the screen. Yeah, so as you can see, I have all the clips here. I actually have like some good footage. This is gonna be like a good video, actually. Okay, so usually I'll close this out because whenever they pop up like that, all the clips are like out of order, which is obviously not gonna work. So I'll open Finder. As you can see right here, it says Canon DC. That's my camera, so that's where I click. I just open the folder that my clips are in, and I will go down to the clips that I'm actually gonna be using for this video. Oh, they're not in this folder. I don't know why they just go to another folder, but whatever. Yeah, they're here. So first I'm just gonna put my packing clips in my iMovie timeline because that's what I'm gonna be working on first, and I don't want to overwhelm myself. If you want to select more than one clip, you can just hold down Command and just drag all the clips that you want. I'm gonna drag all the clips that I want into my timeline. They're in order. As you can see, I have pretty much an hour of footage already, and this is just the packing. We're gonna get this down to probably like 10 minutes or so. I'm not sure. You can see right here, there's an option to stretch out the clips so you can see what you're doing more and cut clips more accurately. I get into like such a zone when I'm editing, so I'm gonna have to remind myself to like talk while I'm editing, because editing is kind of like second nature for me, at least on iMovie. Once I move to Final Cut Pro, it will not be for a little bit. I'll obviously adjust. I've already cut a clip, and I totally like just didn't explain how I did it. So I just kind of find my place where I want the video to start, because usually there'll be like a minute of footage before I even say, hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I'm gonna delete all that usually, unless it's like funny. So basically, to cut a clip, the shortcut to cut a clip is just Command B. You click Command on your keyboard and B, and it cuts a clip. It just cuts the clip in half, and you can get a really accurate cut with that. I remember when I like didn't really know what I was doing, my dad actually taught me the shortcut, but before I knew the shortcut, I would go to edit and go to cut like all the way up here, and that just takes forever. So it's really good to to know the shortcut to make your editing process a lot smoother. One thing that I don't like in my videos is any extra space, like breathing, pauses, anything like that. I don't like to keep that in my video, and I know a lot of other people don't either. Some people don't like it, but I do. Personally, if I'm gonna watch a video, I'm not gonna wanna wait for them to finish exhaling, pausing, anything like that. Personally, I think my viewers are more entertained when clips are back to back and there's no really long pauses, because you wanna keep your audience engaged, you wanna build up that watch time, you wanna make your videos as entertaining as possible. So once I have my clip that says, "Hey guys, welcome back to my channel," I'll add in my intro. So basically my intro, I literally just get it from a previous video and copy paste it. I know a lot of people have asked me about my intro. I made my intro, my brother actually helped me, on panzoid.com. No, this is not sponsored. They have so many different templates you can use for intros and outros, whatever you want really, and you can just kind of like slap your name on it and add your own music. I'm gonna be working on a new one soon, and I need to figure out a song. That took me a while last time. It's hard to find like a catchy song that most people enjoy. Boom, my recent intro song was a hit. Most people that watch my videos just know the lyrics and they sing along to it at the beginning of every video, which I think is so cool. Like, I want an upbeat song because I want to get my viewers excited to watch the video, so we'll figure it out. If you have any song suggestions, let me know down below. Upbeat, catchy, maybe even songs you guys hear in my videos that you like. So then I'll just literally paste my intro. Oh, I cut the clip too, but welcome back to my channel. Out of my boots, huh. Hop on the whip and go roll. Niggas are dying, go boom. I won't even break a sweat. Okay, it's still a little catchy. I haven't listened to it in a while, so. So as you can see, I said, so. I don't want the I cut out most likes, so. So my favorite way to cut a clip really accurately is using these arrows on the computer right here. And as you can see, if you hold down on it, it goes through the clip really slowly. You can go back. So if you want to find like exactly where you want to cut a clip, this is the best way. I'll find where I want to cut the clip with these arrows, and then I'll use my space bar to pause it, and then I'll cut with command B, and I'll just delete the clip that I don't want. I'm actually gonna cut out the so. There's no reason for that. I don't want that in my video, so I'm just gonna cut it out. So I'm gonna start with me explaining exactly what I'm doing in this video to just kind of get to the point, because that's what people want,
which is really unusual.
So you guys see how I paused like really, and then I took like a breath? I'll cut out that breath,
which is really
right there. I'll use command B to cut the clip. So another good tip to get really accurate while cutting clips: if you want to cut a clip and it's too short to cut, you try command B and it makes that sound. You can use the little stretchy thingy, and as you can see, it gave me a little more room. I'm just gonna move the end of the clip to the white line where I'm trying to cut it. That's another good way to get really accurate cutting. So another thing you guys may see in my videos really often is using crop to fill, or the Ken Burns effect. Crop to fill is just where it not zooms into my face kind of slowly, the next clip is just right on my face. So that's what I'm trying to do for this clip. So all you do to crop your face is you'll go up to all these little icons up here, you click this little cropping icon, and I do crop to fill. You just make the square as big or as small as you want it, and I'll put it on my face, and then you just kind of click away and it's there. This is what it looks like now.
Today we're packing.
I usually use crop to fill if I'm trying to add emphasis onto something I'm saying, or if I think something could potentially be slightly funny. I usually use Ken Burns where it slowly zooms in when there's a pause and I'm not talking, just to kind of keep the clip more interesting. I'm not saying or doing anything, but the clip is slowly moving, so it's still kind of entertaining and makes you want to keep watching it because you feel like something's about to happen. Kind of leaves you in suspense. Basically all I'm doing as of now, I'm just kind of cutting my clips, I'm deleting any extra pauses. This step gets really repetitive, so I'm gonna go ahead and do a little more cutting and deleting, and I'll get back to you guys in a second. Okay, it's been like 10-15 minutes and I'm now a minute into the video. So I'm still doing my cutting and deleting, but there's usually a point in the video where I'll pose for a thumbnail, and then I'll go and screenshot that later on before I post it. So I found that spot here. So basically I'm just going to put text on this clip saying that I'm posing for a thumbnail. I usually like people to know because it can be really awkward just like watching me sit there. So I'm gonna go to titles. The title option that I usually use is just this center title. So I'll just click on that and I'll drag it to the spot that I want. I'll just delete all the text that's currently in there, and I'll put the text that I want. I'm just gonna put me posing for a thumbnail. This is just the text it gives you before you do anything to it. So this isn't the text that I usually use. So I'll go up to font, which is right up here, and I will go down. So I usually use Helvetica New medium. And that's what the text looks like now. The next thing I do to the text is I'll take the outline off, which is just like this black trim on the text. So as you can see, there's a little O right here. You literally just click that and it'll take the outline off. Then the next thing I do to this text is I'll make it smaller. I like it to be small, and that's kind of like the aesthetic that I'm going for. I don't know how to say it. You know, like literally every YouTuber does it. So I'll just go to the number right here. This is the size of your text. I'll usually take it to 58, a perfect size where it's really small, so it's not really noticeable, but it's also big enough so people can actually read it. This actually is a little big. Okay, I'm gonna change this to Helvetica New, whatever, the regular one, instead of medium. Okay, that looks better. I don't want this text to be on the clip the whole time because I am gonna be screenshotting it for a thumbnail, and I don't want me posing for a thumbnail on the actual thumbnail. If you guys see this blue strip right here, that is my title. It's currently 4 seconds long, so I'm just gonna grab it, bring it down to like, yeah, that's it. I don't even know how long this is. What is it? 0.6 seconds. So as you can see, it looks like this now. It doesn't draw too much attention. No, I actually need a thumbnail right now. So something else that's really common for YouTubers to do is this transition where it'll just kind of slide to the next clip really fast, and you'll hear like the, it's a golf hit. That's what you're hearing. It's just a really fast and simple transition. So I'm going to show you guys exactly how to do that today. I'm actually about to use it in my video. As you can see up here, there's a transitions tab. So you're just going to click on that and you're going to go down to slide right. You can do slide left. I like slide right better. I don't know why. So you just want to drag that between the two clips you're trying to transition. So as you can see right now, it's really slow. That's not usually how you see it in YouTube videos. So you're just gonna double click on this and it'll give you an option to make the transition slower or faster. So right now it's at 1 second and you're gonna put it to 0.2 seconds. So that's like a lot faster. And then you're going to apply it. And as you can see, it's a lot faster now. By itself, it doesn't have that sound effect you usually hear. So you're gonna go to audio. It's already right here because I use it really often. So you're just gonna click golf hit. So you're just gonna drag this right between the two clips and it should rest kind of right in the middle right there because you already made the transition faster. As you can see, it just rolls perfectly.
Okay.
And then also sometimes the transition sound can be a little too loud for my liking, so I'll just kind of bring it down to like 50. Okay. So something else that's important in YouTube videos is music, of course, and it can be really tough to find music that's good that won't get copyrighted. I've been copyrighted, not actually gotten copyright strike, but I've gotten a lot of warnings for certain songs I've tried to use in videos. Whenever you upload your video, once you give it like the 10 minutes to process, you will get an email if a song in that video cannot be used, or you will not be able to monetize your video with that song in it. You guys ask me where I get my songs a lot. I'll usually use like rap song instrumentals for music that I already listen to. I like to use less common rap song instrumentals because they're less likely to get copyrighted. But if you're trying to use instrumentals for songs that are really popular, you have more of a chance of getting copyrighted. But recently, I haven't really even been using rap instrumentals. I've kind of been going more with like the chill music. I get a lot of questions where I get that music. I've been using SoundCloud. SoundCloud has a lot of good lo-fi hip-hop type of music, which is really good for YouTube videos just to kind of have in the background. A lot of these songs that they have on here, you can also find on YouTube. So if I see a song, I might go back to YouTube and look it up and download it that way. But sometimes I just get them straight from SoundCloud. So basically, you can just look up lo-fi chill. You will definitely find a lot of good instrumentals. They have all these playlists of all these songs, and I'll just kind of go through them and find some that I like. It's actually pretty easy if you like this type of music. So then to save it, they have like soundcloud.mp3.com or youtube.mp3.com. Pretty sure they're not legal, but everyone does it. I'll just type in SoundCloud to MP3 and I kind of just go to whatever pops up. They're all the same. For example, if I like, let's see, this song. See, I actually do like that. So you're just going to click on the song. You're gonna copy the link and then you're gonna paste it in this SoundCloud MP3 website and you're just gonna click download. So then it'll give you the option to download the song and you click download the song and boom, that's literally all you do. Then you can just go here in Finder and you'll see it in your downloads, or you can take it straight off of Google, whatever you're using, and just drag it right into the video. It is so easy. So when it comes to music, I think the smartest thing to do is to add your music once you're done editing the video. But sometimes I like to edit to the music, especially if I'm trying to make it artsy. It depends. But for this video, I'm talking through most of it. I just kind of like to have music in the background, so I'm not editing to the music. But towards the end, when I add the beach footage, when I'm not talking in a lot of it, I will kind of edit to the beat of the music at some point. It is safest to go with type beats. If you like rap instrumentals, you can just go to YouTube. You can look up any artist you like. For example, Lil Uzi type beat. Search that up and it'll give you so many instrumentals that are like Uzi songs, but not quite. So you won't get copyrighted. They're free to use. You can actually feel safe using their music and know that your video is not gonna get taken down or whatever. I'll just show you guys what it's like to add a song. I'll just go to downloads and let's just drag this one. These are all from SoundCloud. I'll just kind of put it where I want it. I'll drag it into my project. You definitely don't want the music to be too overpowering. That could be annoying if you're watching someone's video and you can barely hear them because the music's too loud. I like it to just faintly be there. Like at some points you can't even hear the music. That's usually where I like it. But it also depends on what type of vibe I'm going for. If I want something to be more upbeat, I'll turn up the music a little bit so it's more noticeable, but it's still not overpowering, okay? I mean, it depends on the music. For this video, 11% is good. But then sometimes, especially with rap instrumentals or there's more bass, I'll turn it down to like 4. I currently don't do any color correcting to my videos, but I love how some YouTubers filter their videos. I actually don't know how to do that, so I should probably learn because I really like how that looks. But I know a lot of you guys tell me how my videos are really like raw and you guys like that. Let me know what you guys think you like better. So as you guys can see, my editing's pretty simple. There's not much to it. Once you get the hang of it, it's so easy. I've been doing this for 4 years, so it is a little easier to me than it might be for some of you guys that are just starting. But yeah, guys, that is basically the basics to editing. This can kind of just teach you how to put a basic video together and just kind of practice editing and get better at these techniques, because these are kind of your base and the most important things you can know while editing, at least for my style. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and end this video here. If you guys enjoyed it, definitely make sure to let me know so I can do a part 2 for you guys. If you guys have gotten all the way to the end of this video and you have not subscribed yet, please make sure to do so. Also, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.